most humble of settings, a stable where animals come for shelter and to feed. God's Son will be born not in a palace, but in a poor little town named Bethlehem and in a stable. Now the angel Gabriel has been rather busy. He or she is God's messenger, and Gabriel has spoken to Mary 9 months ago, and then Gabriel spoke to Joseph. Joseph needed Gabriel's reassurance.
The story, as we have already seen, involves several people, but at the heart of the Christmas story is one tired husband, Joseph, and one exhausted wife, Mary. The journey has been incredibly long and difficult.
They have returned to Joseph's hometown for reasons of taxation, and it is here in Bethlehem where Joseph and Mary settle in for the night for the birth of their baby.
Although she did not make the trip, Mary's cousin Elizabeth is largely responsible for Mary's physical, emotional stability. Mary stayed with Elizabeth for several of these last months. Elizabeth knew all about the sacredness of Mary's child. And Elizabeth was like a rock for Mary, a friend, a counselor, a woman-to-woman comforter. The world is indebted to Elizabeth.
They sang to the shepherds, and they probably hovered over the stable as Mary delivered her baby. Nothing could be more fitting on such a night than the presence of angels. God has thousands upon thousands of angels.
The angels that very night told the shepherds all about the newborn king, the savior of the world. How thrilling that must have been for the theme. And then the angels actually begin to sing to the shepherds. Imagine such a sound and such an amazing sight. And those shepherds couldn't run into town quick enough.
And sure though, they found Joseph and Mary and the baby Jesus, just as the angels had told them. And guess what? The shepherds couldn't keep quiet about what they had just seen. They told everybody.
Long before anyone in Bethlehem ever knew about it, a special star up in the heavens had been moving closer and closer to Bethlehem. It had a purpose, to guide the wise men from the east to the town where the Savior would be born. We have come to call it the Bethlehem Star. There are many theories about this star. It had even been a prophecy from the Old Testament, and sure enough, it guided the wise men. wise men made their long journey and found Joseph and Mary and their baby son. And they brought gifts, gold, incense, and myrrh. Now these were expensive gifts, gifts fit for a king. They would help sustain Jesus' family in the important months to come.
And there you have it, cows and donkeys and sheep, an angel and a whole host of angels, a young mother and her husband, a close friend, excited shepherds, a guiding star, and wise men bringing gifts. But most of all, that tiny baby, Mary's newborn baby, God's son, our Savior, and so we sing.
Thank you.
Kids Quest and our Thursday Teen Quest kids, the elementary kids on Tuesday and the middle school kids on Thursday. It is a privilege to be able to work with them and to be a part of them. Kathy and I work together as a team. Stand up, Kathy. I know they all know you. But... At this church, she is my right hand, only in about 6 million ways. We also want to thank Rachel. If you'll stand up, Rachel is the one who teaches the kids on Tuesday. This is a young lady we all love. This is Katie McKibben, and Katie is there every Tuesday afternoon and every Thursday afternoon. She runs up here, gets up here as soon as she can after her high school classes at the end of the day, that she goes the extra mile, the extra effort, and we appreciate Katie.